Hello students, this is Mamta from Department of Botany. Today we will be studying about water pollution. So first we will understand what is water pollution. Water pollution, as you know, that is whenever there is a change, being a natural or induced change in the overall, that is in the what called the quality of the water, the which reduces its mainly the what the overall its properties and all, and makes it unsuitable and toxic as regards to both let it be for food and also for a man and even the animal health and even for industry, agriculture, fishing and all these, then water is said to be polluted water. So that is any water which may be by natural this one or may be by induced changes takes place in the water and reduces the quality of water, then automatically the water becomes toxic and it is not fit for any, that is human beings and also for even that is even for animals, industries, agriculture and all these, then that water is said to be polluted water. Or even there is once again the definition can be given for that is in other way for the polluted, that is polluted water or water pollution and all, that is what they have given, discharge of any sewage and all these, let it be in any liquid, gaseous or in solid substance, and then automatically the contamination of the water by foreign substances, these automatically may cause direct or indirect, that is indirectly affects the water, and then automatically that water which creates nothing but that is mainly it affects the health of human beings and mainly the domestic animals or any animal and all, then that water which is unfit for industries and even for agriculture and even for that is life of all the organisms and all, then that water is said to be nothing but polluted water. And see, once again, now we have come to know about what is water pollution. Now what that is how many types of water pollutions are there? See, there are four types of mainly pollution of water. First one is physical pollution of water. What do you mean by the word physical pollution? This it includes nothing but there is any color penetration of light, that is mainly color penetration of light, that is whenever a light passes through the water, and even whenever there is a what is called odor, for that is odium, nothing but whenever water has a what is called a foul smell and thing like that, odor, and whenever the water foams, that is the water has not lost its physical overall property and it foams, that is mixed up with all the soaps and all, and once again it is unpleasant, and even the taste and the turbidity and even the suspended particles, that is mainly microorganisms, are all these produce different colors, and what the water, even it may be fishy, that is what is called a smell, foul smell, that water is what we termed as a fishy, or many a times if it is near any thermal power plant and all, then the water gets heated up, that is the boiling temperature of the water goes above that, that is when its thermal properties is being affected and all, then the water is said to be having a physical pollution of water. So that is outwardly, whenever you see the changes in the physical property of water, then that is the one of the reason for the pollution of water. And now coming over to what is called the chemical pollution of water. What actually is this chemical pollution of water? See, this is nothing but a change in the overall, what we call it as an alkalinity or even the pH. Alkalinity means the nothing but the alkali is present in the water is being disturbed, or even the pH, that is the pH means nothing but which has both acid and that is base, and in between these two, that is the water is present which has a neutral, that is the overall the that is neither it is acidic nor it is basic, so it will be neutral. That is why we call the pH of water is 7. And definitely in this pH of water, and that is you will be not only just seeing this pH but also the dissolved oxygen, that is the oxygen that is already dissolved in the water, it should be there, and other gases in the water, they all should be in their own proportions and all. And even it may be caused by somewhat what is called organic or inorganic pollutants. That is, both the organic and the inorganic pollutants are present in water, and both the organic matter, once again, it is divided into biodegradable and non-biodegradable. In organic substances only, which is present in water, is once again it is divided into biodegradable and degradable and all. And several, that is gases, all many of the toxic gases and all the metals and compounds and all much of the chemicals are there in water, and which are mainly inorganic, that is chemicals which are inorganic are present, and these once again are the pollutants which pollute the water, because they also, all these pollutants, and let it be even the biodegradable things, all these pollute the water. And once again, that is, they degrade the water, and automatically the quality will be, that is, decreased. So, that is, whenever there is a chemical pollution of water, then automatically alkalinity of water, it may increase, or even the acidity of water may increase, or even nothing but the pH of the water will not be the same. And once again, what you observe, that is oxygen that is dissolved in water is not in proportion and all, then you will observe nothing but what is called chemical pollution of water. And now coming over to the biological pollution of water, this biological pollution, this is caused by excretory, mainly by excretory products or waste products, and all that is being left by all warm-blooded animals. That is, the warm-blooded animals which leave excretion, all that which is present in the water, and not only just this one, that is even the birds, nothing but your what is called bacteria and the viruses and algae and diatoms, and even nothing but what is called crustaceans, which they will be in water only, and plant toxins and all these are present in what is called as coliri, that is coliriform bacteria, types of bacteria. These all once again the indicator of nothing but what is called the water is contaminated, and indicator all these that fecal matter and all these are present in water indicates that the biological pollution of water, that is the water is being contaminated by life, that is the products which have other beings which have life. So that water we call it as nothing but a biological pollution of water. That is, wherever there is a pollution of water, mainly by animals, crustaceans, bacteria, virus, and many that is diatoms and all these things, then it is said to be biological pollution of water. And now, last but least, that is physiological pollution of water. This physiological pollution of water is caused by several agents such as chlorine, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen, and even that is sulfur, even by sulfate and ketones and all phenyls, amines, and all even that is hydrogen, nothing but hydrogen and even benzene and all these. Even not just this, but even also the chlorinating of water, what it will do is converts phenol to ortho and parachlorophenol. So this chlorination, that is whenever chlorine is being added to water for that is cleaning the water, then automatically the physiological quality of physiological characteristic of water is being lost. That is what happens is here the chlorinating of water usually converts phenol to nothing but ortho and paraphenol, and this water it will lose its taste and it will taste like medicine and all and produce effective odor. That is, the water will have a effective odor. So this we call it as a physiological pollution of water. So once again, on the basis of source and storage of water, water is being classified into nothing but groundwater pollution and surface water pollution. Now coming over to the groundwater pollution, this is caused by nothing but the what is called as the domestic the mainly domestic what called waste, that is induced and domestic waste and even nothing but industrial waste and all these. So whenever a groundwater is being affected, that is you have a borewell and it is being affected by the nearby what is called the pit and all, and definitely it will affect the water with bacteria and all, and even by industrial that is waste and all. This water, whenever it is that is being affected by industrial waste and even by agricultural waste, then runoff from the water, that is what we call it as in the runoff the volume from the water, and all these will make the groundwater pollution. That is, when the water flows along with even effluents and all, that is much of the chemicals and all, then water is said to be groundwater pollution. And now surface water pollution. See, that is surface water means nothing but the water flows over the surface of the earth. And this and once again, this water, it's consists of the many sewage waste and even nothing but particulate soil and even much of the what is called that is infections, agents and all, that is virus, bacteria and all, and even nothing but chemical compounds and minerals and all these. So these radioactives, once again, that is much of the thermal pollutants and organic chemicals and all these are being added to water, then that water is said to be surface water pollution. That is, for all flowing water, much of the rivers, they will be affected likewise. And next is lake water pollution. So it is mainly because of huge nutrition, that is mainly huge area, that is what we call it as a huge amount of nutrition and organic matter and all these activities. And even what is called eutrophication, that is once again they have asked for what is eutrophication, that is it is a process where that is river water and mainly that is even if what is called the lake water, it is being affected by chemicals, organic matter and all this, and definitely they will be even affected by activities of man, and that even that is even by what is called eutrophications and all. So this type of water we call it as lake water pollution, that is the pollution that is which affects the lake water is called as lake water pollution. And we have last but least, that is river water pollution. It is mainly because of nothing but increased population. River water pollution, as you all know, wherever the rivers are there, definitely the pollution near that area will be more, and definitely this will pollute the water because of man using the river and also contaminating it, and industrialization and urbanization and even nothing but increased living standards and even broad sphere of human activities, all this will affect the river water and makes it polluted. So these are the types of that is pollution what you observe and all. And next, coming over to the harmful effects on man, that is how the water has a harmful effects on man and all. So this we will be studying in next class. Thank you.